Actually, in fact, call me Pepe.
You know, say this your name, heart of
Pepe. Just say Pepe.
Pepe? After Pepe. Pepe. Every other Pepe, Nakanta. Have you?
Nasona.
Oh, ah. Sorry, money.
Thank you, Perpetua.
You so sweet.
Hey.
How much?
Wait, now, maybe they go. We go share and for
you. You say, wait, how much did they share money for you? They talk say, wait.
Your body too, they
hot. Mommy, I like money. No reason,
amma. Take.
Wait first. How much did they
check? Which one be your own? Now, not the same thing. Not the same thing. You know, say, you know, sabi book. Not the same.
You say, no, sir.
Where will they go? You don't.
So we don't do book for you now. Hey.
Boyo, boyo, Jai, make one more balance in them every fair. Jai, I take time and leave she be troublemaker number one.
Hey! You don't want to buy it!
We didn't want your now. Hey!
$3,000
Leave
me now. Leave
my
shirt.
I should do what?
Leave my shirt first.
I'm not leaving first. I won't go give that egg. I beg. I don't want trouble. Give me $3,000 Come on, this is your time. Give me $3,000 I don't want this. Give me my $3,000
Amarachi. Amarachi.
Give me $3,000 Give me my $3,000 For God's sake, give me my $3,000 We go fight though. Give me my $3,000
That girl should better not return to this house. Unless Amarachi won't come back to this house. Okay, after dealing with her this night, Amarachi, I will deal with her.
I agree with you.
You agree with me? Oh, finally, we agreed on something. Hey, Mama. That girl looked us finish and tied us up. Hey, Mama? She put Igbo substance in our food. Mama, Igbo? Among them, ko Igbo, ko kolos, ko wolu, tila inani. No water, no food. She even stole my money. Ha ha. Mama, mbano. You see this one? She's not going to escape it. I will deal with Amarachi. I swear to God Almighty.
I agree with you, but not on that one. Yes. I agree with you that she has a spiritual problem.
Well, we still agree on something.
Yes. And we have to help her. She needs help.
Help her how? How do we help her?
You will take her to a spiritualist, a reverend father, a seer, even a native doctor. Any one of them that can help her. She needs help. We are all she's got. She is your daughter and my granddaughter.
Mama.
Please.
I will not guarantee that. I will not. But what I know is that, okay, for Abania, if any again, Abania, everything will happen this night. After beating her, she will not be able to look at my face. Okamarachi, maybe I can't attack. Maybe you. Maguire, I'm open here.
Ibekwe, where
are you? Mugo, you put your nanny. Get you. Get him, get you. I go to
Ibekwe. Take it easy, I beg of you. Eh? Easy.
I'm not taking it easy. Mama, I'm not taking it easy. Amarachi, she made me to break eggs for nothing. Mm-hmm. 3,000 naira now for half. I counted 3,000 naira and lavished it for nothing. Mama, see, let me tell you. One day, people will wake up and see that she have killed us and buried us.
No.
Mama, this one is not no. It is going to happen.
Ibekwe.
Look at what is going on now. And you are telling me no.
Ibekwe, it will never get to that. That's why we have agreed that she has a spiritual problem. And we will help her.
Mama, Oshiebe weti Igbo. Kebo Oshiebe Igbo. Obere nwa hake. Kebo Oshiebe Igbo.
Is part of the spiritual problem.
I will pursue that spiritual problem for her body. Let her come back this night first. I'm waiting for her. Mom, I'm waiting for her.
Where we and why you?
I'm
Dajua.
She be troublemaker number one. Amarachi pepe chua. In a day, obelancin and maybe fella. They say one and I ever in the trouble. If she no find trouble, trouble go find and come. Now, which can pick in no be this year. Joy, if you want trouble now. Oh, yeah, call Amarachi,
Amarachi,
go call her gangi, and they go deal with you. But if you want make them happy, yo, call them Perpetua,
Perpetua.
Everything go send them in there.
Yo.
If you want make trouble, oh, yeah, call Amarachi.
Where is he going to? Is he angry?
No, he's very happy. Oh, he's very happy. To see him jumping with joy. Get up, dress up now before he gets back here.
Dress up, where am I going to? Where are we going to?
If I were you, I would do what I'm asked to do. You know, Wage, before I'm again, actually, at Eba.
What is going on now?
Eh, what is going on?
I lied to you. How did I get there? Because I knew I was still, I slept outside last night.
Odoku, you magically got in here. You know, Wage, say so before I'm again, at Eba. Onyaro.
Leave it to me.
No, he will clap for you. I'm clapping for you already.
Mama, what are you planning on?
I said, get down and dress before he gets back.
But I have no bath.
You have no bath. Dress. Rida, you're
not angry. Papa's angry.
Eh, he's happy. He's very happy.
Good morning, Father.
My angel. How are you? Listen, baby. Welcome.
Father, good morning.
Good morning. This one that you people are here. Hope all is well.
Father, all is not well. We are not doing well. Ekwensu na ndo ogoro oru ji bi nkwaru ngworo.
Ekwensu kwa.
Yes.
Holy Mary. How? What happened?
This little chinch is possessed. She's highly possessed. Osunotu.
Mr. Ibekwe.
But I'm serious. Oh.
Possessed?
Mm-hmm.
How?
There is a spirit that usually possess her and make her cause trouble everywhere. She rebel at home. Yes. She attacked people's children. Causing trouble here and there. Every day, every now and then.
Little girl, what is your name?
My name is Bushra.
Father Bernard, her name is Amarachi. That is the name I, her father, named her. And as an Igbo man, I insist that her name will be Amarachi, not Perpetua.
Amarachi is
the... Hey! What did I tell you? I said you should call me Perpetua.
I told you.
Perpetua!
I told you. This girl, Obonjenge, just yesterday, she tied me up, including her grandmother. She tied both of us up.
Holy Mary.
This girl. Oko Obonjenge ndi nnukwu ya.
Young girl, you like to be called Perpetua.
Simple.
How come that name?
It's my baptismal name, oh.
Is that correct?
Yes. That is her baptismal name. But Amarachi is her first name. I chose that her first name will be Amarachi. Like I said, I'm an Igbo man. Mm-hmm. So her name is Amarachi. And if I hear Perpetua again,
not in my office.
So we'll take it again in this father's office.
Eh?
Yes!
We'll take it again.
Father, Mr. I told Ibe, you
that this head is possessed.
Mr.
This head in deliverance. So.
Little girl. Do you think that causing problems, tying your father and your grandmother, will make them see your point?
That one was another different case. Another different battle.
Eh?
Face that one later.
Different battle? How?
Since they refuse to tell me who my mother is, they refuse to show me where she is. They refuse to tell me anything about her, even take me to my mother. Is it hard to ask for?
Mr. Ibekwe.
Father.
Is that true?
Answer now. Mr. Ibekwe, is that true?
Ibekwe, great Inkonta knows why you are here. But for the record, state your mission.
Nkume the great seer,
mm-hmm.
You were highly recommended to solve my problem. And that is why I brought my
daughter here. She will be greater than her mother. Yes. I see her surrounded with great fortune and wealth. She is a child of great value. A child destined to turn the situation of your family around for good. She is a very valuable child. But I see hindrances. It's not very clear. But I see you in the middle of these hindrances. I see you standing in the way.
You!
But to clear these hindrances, we have to perform some rituals. Ibekwe, you have to come with two white cocks. 7 tubers of yam and 7 white kola nuts. Ibekwe, there will be consequences in the event that your actions stand in the way of our breakthrough. It will tear your family apart. So, go and get the items for that ritual.
So, you are my angels. Yahwa!
Ngwa!
Ngwa!
She be troublemaker number one. Amarachi perpetual.
Oh, Papa, wait. Wait. Let's discuss this as two adults. Let's talk. Let's talk. One on one.
Two adults?
Yes.
And who are the adults?
Two of us now. Me and you.
Here! Ochim. Okay. What is it that you want us to talk about? Where can you go?
Hey, okay. The thing is that every parent wants their children to progress, to be bigger than them. But my own father is my hindrance. Why?
Amarachi, what are you talking about? What do you mean by I'm your hindrance?
You know, yeah, the Honorable Dibia. He said that I am supposed to be a big woman, a rich woman, but you are hindering me. Why?
Oh, God. So I'm doing everything possible to solve this my problem, this my particular problem. But you are making it look like I'm wasting my time. Okay?
Don't run away from this question. Because even the father that you took me to, he confirmed that I'm a shining star, kiri-kiri star. But something is hindering me, which the Dibia has already said that you are my hindrance. So what is going on? Is it because you are poor? You don't want me to progress? What is going on now? What is it? Did I offend you? Because you are poor and you have said that I will be bigger than you. I will be a rich woman, a big woman. You are not tying me down. But you want us to be the same. You want me to be in your shoes. But God forbid. You know what? I am your match. Let's go.
Lovina. Lovina. Carol?
Eh?
Lovina, sit down. Carol?
Yes.
What is it?
Lovina, I want you to do me a favor. Please, I want to know where those dogs that beat me up, where they live.
Me, do you a favor. Please, I don't know. Go Pokwan, what is it?
Lovina, nothing. I just want to know where those girls live. Finish.
Caro. Caro. How many times did I call you?
Lovina. Lovina, listen to me. Are they sisters?
They are not.
Very good. That means they don't live together.
Uh-huh.
So now, that's better. I want to know where they live now, so I'll know how to arrange myself.
Don't involve me. I don't know where they stay. I don't. What is your problem now, Caro? Why are you looking for them?
Lovina, just tell me nothing. I just want to know.
Don't say I told you. Agunyakwanam, don't say I told you.
No problem. I will not involve you. Myself, I just want to know where they live. Thank you very much. Eh? Have a nice market. Fine market.
Say that again. Sorry, I don't think I know you. Excuse me. You don't know me, Robin. Who are you? When you go on car.
So you mean nothing came out of your visit to Reverend Father and Mume?
Waste of time.
Yeah.
Father Bernard was even siding her, saying that we are the ones giving her problem, causing her to rebel.
And what did Mume say?
That one was even out of it. He was off key, he was totally off point. He said that we are the ones standing in her way of greatness, that I'm a hindrance to her prosperity. Can you imagine that kind of useless talk? Nonsense talk, I need a query. Nkume just want a query. Hindrance to my dog. Told me, don't even want to say anything.
Greatness and prosperity.
Yes. When he mentioned some items that he needed for rituals, that was when I realized that he wanted to rape me. Mpume cherum guy. Mwa ko cherum, mwa bu guy. Ko cheberu guy. Tawao zubo zubo. I left her. Left her.
It's okay, son. It's okay. Go in and rest. Go to bed. Tomorrow, you will take her to Akolisa, the prophetess, the final solution.
Another spiritualist?
She is a prophetess.
So tomorrow we'll go again?
Don't worry, all will be well. With time,
Amarachi. Marachi, you see this trouble you are causing? Hi.
Mankete. Se onye kota ogodie kotare. Mano gade.
Prophetess, that is it oh. She rebel at home and she attacks people outside. In fact, she continues looking for people's trouble outside. That is why I brought her here for a very serious deliverance. Because this is no longer normal. Uma solotu. Uma solotu, Meka, she belongs somewhere.
She's possessed.
I said it.
An angry spirit is hovering around her. Her late mother's spirit is hovering around her.
Hey! Mama doing it.
Sarah! Shut up before I slaughter her for you.
Shut up.
I'm seeing a very big problem. Very big problem. And she is at the center. She's at the center. She will cause a very big problem that you cannot carry. Aye! Holy.
Great one. What can I do? What can I do to stop all this problem that is coming?
Fasting and prayer. Aye, holy. Fasting and prayer.
Fasting and prayer.
7 days dry fasting and prayer. You need to pray your way out. Hey! Oh! 7 days fasting and prayer with 7 candles. Different colors. Different colors of candle. After that, there are other things you need to buy. Mustard seed. New Testament mustard seed. Olive oil. Olive oil from Mount Sinai. From Mount Sinai. From Mount Sinai. The garments. Elijah's garments. Elijah's garments. Oh, you buy Elijah's garments. It's needed too. Water. Hey, water from river. Oh, from river sign. Oh, the holy water. Hey! Oh! Oh! Hey! Hey!
Mama, that was it, oh. I can't even remember all the items he mentioned.
Yeah.
There were too many.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
Oh, Mama, you see, at this point, I just wish Patricia aborted that child. Because if I believe her, no, this is not what I ordered for.
Stop that. Don't say that again. Don't say that. Hey. You said, Ako Lisa said trouble is coming.
Yes. He said that we are yet to see the worst of this change. This little change. He said that she will ignite a fire in my hands. That will not rope her, but will rope me instead.
And Mume said something similar. I think there is a connection.
What are you talking about?
Akolisa said, you are the hindrance.
Huh? So what is the relationship here with what Akolisa said?
Either the hindrance or the obstacle, huh, will take the heat. The girl, your daughter, is exonerated. You are everything, the heat, everything comes back to you. That's the connection. So they are saying almost the same thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, listen, so, what one more?
So, Mama, what are we going to do?
Honestly, I wish I have an answer to that.
Jesus. What did you say, Yapo?
My dear, she ambushed me and gave me a first attack. Hey, I was carrying a bucket of water on my head, coming back from the borehole. Out of nowhere, this girl just appeared and gave me a resounding slap in my eye. I went dark. The last thing I saw were lightning and stars. Nya, clickly star.
This girl get mind though.
Hey,
as in
I couldn't see anything.
She get more.
So she began to pound on me.
See voltage.
She even said she's coming for the rest of you.
Huh? No level.
Hey. Oh, Pepe. See now.
What's up with this?
Maybe smarting.
What's happened now? You said not be smart. What's happened? Now moto jam you.
Maybe moto jam how?
What's going to happen? Talk on now. What happened?
She said they lay ambush. Give her water, water. Now baptism, now they baptize her like this.
You don't mean it. So, who be them?
Caroline. That Caroline, where you know. Now I give her water, water.
Carol?
Of her life.
Carol?
Yes, sir.
Hey! She not the fear.
I swear.
What to say? You always talk say you get power. as they beat you, like, the name is saying me, I know they're safe now.
She even dropped message, say she they come after us, one after the other.
That's so she talk, oh.
But for me, no level. I gallant.
Wow.
Wow.
She they come after us.
Really, wow.
Which is she talk sense. That.
Okay. No wahala.
But Tango say, anyways. Tango say you come, at least you go stay with China and Sam. Make I go do something for us.
Hey, thank God though. Thank God say me I come see you because as you see me, if you see the way I sneak. Hey.
Sneaky.
My mama tell me to say make I come to so I come there. I don't want to say make I go see my friends. Say I don't know whether they safe. Make I go see my friend.
Taiko.
Or say make I just wait small. Then I just like this sneak come out, come see you now. But thank God, Shona, they're safe. And they do something with the very important for us.
Amma, you go wait, stay with your friends more. This is your friend where they fight for you now.
I wish I go wait. How I wish I feel. God, no say me, I like all my friends. Say, if now, if say me, I did there. Carol, no, if you do you this thing. But as you know, say, you know, go know when something will happen. Like this now. You will not know. Something will just bam, happen. And, I go.
Perpetua, na so?
No, be saying so. You don't say I go there for you. I feel there for you, but I did do something for house.
So, like this now, you leave us for street, Abby?
No, be street I live in, and no be your house, please. I leave you for your house. You are the con.
Like this now, Pepe don't leave us for street, though.
Na so? No, be small thing. See my body now, see my eye.
What people?
See me as I be.
Me like see, me I tell you from today, me I go dey fight my fight. Oh.
Na so you go
see who
now.
They fight for.
Na so you go.
Smart thing now, she don't dey shake body like a jellyfish. She don't run so. No wahala.
For himself.
Me I gallant. Make Caroline come.
You don't mean it. That's the problem. You don't know who you are with. You don't know what I can do. You don't trust me. That's the problem. You mean you attacked a member of her gang? Hi, in Korea. When you think back upon, I was beating, she was begging. I was beating, she was begging. I knew at all.
Emma, those girls, you don't know them. They would definitely come back for you.
I am waiting for them. In the chair, I will one after the other. I will deal with them. All I swear to God, eh? Wait till I go do them. You know, they are very surprised because I took them from the leg. You understand? They didn't know now. You know, everybody is scared of them and all. I dealt with them. Hi,
Caro. Hey, you don't know those girls in this village. Anya ya fukwa gefe. I'm not involved.
Leave that thing. Leave that thing. You don't trust me. You don't know I'm here to protect even yourself. I will help you, don't worry. See, they're even scared of me now. If you watch the way they are moving now, they are not moving very well. It's because of me.
Caro.
Hi.
You're proud of yourself.
My friend, you're supposed to buy me cold malt.
I just pray to last. I'm also happy for you. I'm happy for you.
This Caroline game mind though. Huh? She attacked Chinasa. Like she beat her like small picking. She even says she's coming for the rest of us. Who knows the next victim? She might even be targeting me now. It's better I'll just be staying indoor from now on. I'll be staying indoor. Because what if I'm walking on the street now? She'll just attack me. I'm not ready for her troubles. At least until Chinasa recovers. I'll be staying indoor for now. This girl is very mean. Fear!
Amarachi. Amarachi. This one, you're seated calm and quiet. Is all well? Have you committed again or are you planning to commit? Eh? Hey. Amarachi. You know the last time you were this calm, I asked. And you said you were having quiet time. And at the end of the day, your quiet time became a plan for a big problem. Eh?
So have you committed or are you planning to commit? M1.
Mama, I thought you had to go out. Go out now.
I'm going to the market, Amarachi. There is food in the pot. Please, Mwam, stay out of trouble. Oh, Nemo, stay out of trouble, I beg of you. Oh?
Fire, fire. Jai, me kwanu obelansi ne me bife. Jai, achecha me life mwoke o. She be troublemaker number one. Amarachi pepe chua. In a day, obelansi ne me bife. This is one and I ever in the trouble. If she no find trouble, trouble go find and come. Na quiz can pick in no be this year. Joy, if you want trouble now, oh yeah, call Amarachi.
Amarachi
go call her gang, and they go deal with you. But if you want make them happy, yo, call them perpetua. Everything go send them in there. Joy, if you want make trouble, oh yeah, call Amarachi.
Amarachi is sleeping.
At this hour of the day, I really don't understand this recent development with her.
This is unusual, though.
She was all by herself, calm, when I left for the market.
Hey, Ame. I don't know if this is good or bad, though.
It is good. My son, it is good. Anything that keeps her seated, calm, and not running and roving around looking for problem, it is a good one. Is it not better?
Amarachi, calm, settled. Hey, Mama, I think this girl is up to something. Yes! Let me go and check my room first. Because this has sleeping no clear at all. Amarachi sleeping. Okay.
Amarachi. Adokwanda. Amarachi. Okay.
Mama now. What is it?
Yeah. What are you running from? What have you committed again, Mwam? Eh?
You tried. Because if it were to be my enemies that came here, and
your enemies. So you're running from your enemies. Hey! Chibu anozo.
She be troublemaker number one. Amarachi pepe chua. This is one and I ever in the trouble. If she no find trouble, trouble go find and come. Na quiz can pick in no be this year. Joy, if you want trouble now, oh yeah, call Amarachi.
Amarachi
go go agangi yo, and they go deal with you. But if you want me,
there used to be a tree around here. I can't find the tree anymore. Oh my goodness, how do I locate Ibekwe's house now? It's been a long time. Hello, little girl.
Hello, big girl.
Okay, I'm looking for one Mr. Ibekwe. Can you help me? Have you seen him around?
Okay, I'm Mr. Ibekwe. Where did they write Mr. Ibekwe? Am I Mr. Ibekwe?
No, I can't locate
it. I get that!
This little girl is so rude. What arrogance!
Her mother has failed to raise her well. Mothers of these days, if you cannot take care of your child, why bring her to the world? This little girl will grow up now and become a prostitute or an armed robber or something. Just look at her. Obviously, she's from a broken home because a child with a proper upbringing will never be rude to anybody. Where is Ibekwe's house now? What do I do now?
Where is Ijunwa? Went to her house, she's not there. Where could she be? Could it be that she's at Chinasa's house? Oh, I don't want to go there. This girl might catch me. Let me try first.
If she no find trouble, trouble go find and come. Wow. Now which kind picking will be this year? Joy, if you want trouble now, oh yeah, call Amarachi. Amarachi go go agangi yo, and they go deal with you. But if you want make them happy yo, call them Pepe Chua. Everything go send them in there. Joy, if you want make trouble, oh yeah, call Amarachi.
Everything is still the same. Anybody home? Hello?
Young lady, who are you? Who are you and what do you want? Are you not the one I'm talking to? Who are you?
Mama, what is going on here?
Thank God you're here. She walked in here. I asked her who she is or what she wants. She refused talking to me.
Patricia! Patricia, you!
Patricia?
Nice.
Yeah.
I'm impressed. At least your eyes are still functioning. Unlike Mama, she's beginning to lose hers.
Patricia?
Point of correction. My name is Mrs. Patra Okezie.
Patricia, if you like, change your name. If you like, change your DNA. If you even like, we are the biggest we've won in this world. That is not of my business, so. What are you doing in my house?
Ibekwe. So you're still very poor?
I beg your pardon.
Yeah. Everything around still feels the same. Nothing has changed.
What do you want?
Well, you don't have anything that I want. I'm here to see my daughter.
Over my dead body. Did you hear me, Claire? I said over my dead body.
You are here to see your daughter.
After 15 years.
No, Patricia, answer me. Do you have a daughter? Now listen to me and listen good. If that is what brought you to my house, you better go back, oh, because it will never work. Patricia, it will not work for you. Caro, wait!
Hi!
What is it?
Hi!
Caro, what is it? Eh?
This guy, you are lucky, you are lucky, you are lucky today.
Caro, calm down.
How you're still pursuing her, ignoring the three of us, eh?
Come on, shut.
Hi!
Caro,
calm down now.
Caro,
respect us.
Caro,
What trouble has she caused again?
Sir, have you forgotten what Amarachi and her friends did to me? Have you forgotten?
Is that Amarachi?
Amarachi, I will kill you in this village.
Karu, you see me here, her father. Her grandmother is here as well. You should at least respect the fact that we are both here and pardon her. You saw us in your house the other day, and you saw how we condemned what she and her friends did to you. Please, just calm down, Biko.
My daughter, please, I beg of you. We've come to your house, we've pleaded, even with your father. Please forgive her.
Biko.
Forgive her, we've cautioned her. Oh?
Amarachi, unless I don't catch you outside, what I will do to you, I will deal with you. Change.
Karoli,
no problem.
Biko.
Hello. I'm sorry for all the troubles she has caused you. Actually, I am her mother.
Hi. Good afternoon, ma.
Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you, ma.
Here. This is for everything she's done to you. Please don't attack her again.
Huh?
Okay? She's just a little girl.
Yes, ma. Thank you very much, ma.
It's okay.
Thank you very much, ma.
Nothing.
Hi. Thank you very much, ma.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
All right.
Hi. Hi, your mother. Hi.
Show off. Omukabana Muropo. My friend, get away, you.
Back to why I am here. I'm here for my daughter.
Which daughter?
Mm.
I said, quick daughter, after how many years? 15 good years. You're not worthy to be a mother.
Are you my mother?
Yes, baby, I'm your mother.
Magola.
I was so rude to you out there.
It's nothing, baby.
Sorry. This is Mr. Ibekwe. This is his mother. I'm his daughter. And you're my mother. This is our house.
Oh, nice.
Yes. Allow me now.
Allow you what?
Allow her come and meet me now. Let her greet her mother.
Come where?
Who are you?
Hey! Let me meet my mother.
Mama, you come here.
Ask her. Where has she been all these years?
Nah.
It's been good years.
My mother.
She left when you were barely 6 months. Did you hear me?
Baby, don't worry. I'll come back for you. I will shake up the heavens just to reunite
Mommy.
With you. I will do everything possible to make sure I get
Mommy.
You.
Who are you?
Mommy.
Patricia, not in this life. Leave my house.
I have told you before, my name is not Patricia. My name is Mrs. Patra Okezie.
Get away from here, my friend.
Mommy, you're killing me. You're killing me.
Baby, I'll come back for you.
I love you already.
I love you too, baby. Ibekwe,
what?
I will come back for my child. You cannot stop me from having my child. I will definitely come back for her.
Patricia,
mark my words.
I will be waiting for you. I will be prepared, waiting for you. My friend, get out from here. Bunkanka wig, Krishna Ben for. Itanoi, Bunkanka wig, Bebobe. Come now, come and pick her. No cockpit. Show my for. I'll be waiting. Oh yeah.
Are you serious?
Yes. What I'm giving you is first-hand information. I saw her with my two eyes. Amarachi's mother is back to this village. And I think she's trying to get back with Ibekwe.
Ah, don't say that again now.
I'm sorry if what I'm saying breaks your heart, but that is the truth. She's very rich now, elegant, classic. She came back with a car and she even gave me a bundle of money because of the trouble I had with her daughter. I threatened that wherever I see her outside that their compound, that I'm going to deal with her. She paid me off. Ha! You don't even have a space, so the way I'm seeing things.
You mean she came back from wherever she's coming from to come and drag Ibekwe with me? Eh? After she abandoned him for years.
Exactly.
Hi. Did she find a husband wherever she's coming from?
See, all this question you are asking now, I don't know. All I came to do is to give you this information.
Hi.
What will I do now?
I don't know, but shine your eyes. Shine your eyes, oh. If not, they will snatch Ibekwe from your palm.
Hi. I'm finished.
Hi. Chai, chai, chai. My own grandchild. Eh? Come on. They have no right at all stopping you from embracing that child. She is your daughter. Hi!
Mama. Eh? You needed to see how eager she was to come and meet me. But they stopped her.
Hi.
That is obvious. They are not going to let you have custody of her. At least not without a fight. So my daughter, tell me, what are your plans towards this?
Papa, Ibikwe did not pay my bride price, did he?
Exactly. Yeah. Not at all. Not at all.
So correct me if I'm wrong. By our tradition, he has no right to claim the child.
You are right, my daughter. A man cannot claim a child if he did not pay the bride price of the child's mother. So no marriage, no fatherhood.
Remember, she gave birth in that house. And she abandoned this child when she was 6 months. They practically raised that child. I think they have a good case here.
Mama, I want my daughter back. And I know she wants to unite with me. I will do everything possible to reunite with my daughter. I want her back.
My daughter, if I may ask, where does your husband stand on this?
Papa, he's with me on this.
Very good. We must fight. We must contest for the child custody.
Yes.
So go and get prepared.
Papa, do whatever it takes. I want my daughter back. Let me know what you need. Before I leave, I will leave some money with you so you can mobilize and consult whoever you need to consult.
It's okay, my daughter. Don't worry again. I will throw my weight on this.
Papa, thank you.
Very good.
My daughter, let me go and prepare food for you to eat.
Please, hurry, hurry.
Yeah.
Do not be afraid. I'll be by your side. That child belongs to you. Do not worry again. That child is my granddaughter. There's no way they will take her away from you. Not under my watch.
Baby! My baby! I was actually coming from your shop. Enter, let me drop you at home. Baby! Baby, I'm talking to you now. Come and enter, let me drop you off. Hey! My love. My love, wait now. What is the matter?
Ibekwe, what is it? What?
Why are you giving me attitude? What have I done?
Your baby mama is back, right? I thought you said it's over between the both of you, Ibekwe.
Yes, we are done.
Okay, so what is she doing in your house?
My baby, it is not what you think.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay, let me guess. I'm your village girlfriend who keeps you warm. Why you go about making plans on how to secretly marry your baby mama, right?
What do you mean by that?
What do I mean by that? Ngwasazia means, what did she come to do?
See, baby, you are getting it all wrong.
Okay.
Yes, my baby mama came around, but it's not what your mind is telling you. Yes.
So what did she come to do, Ibekwe? Tell me.
She came to claim custody of our daughter, Marachi.
Really? So? What
do you mean by so? We denied her the access, of course.
Really? I mean you would have allowed her to...
Wait. Are you saying I should have allowed her to take my daughter? Is that what you are saying?
No, really. You know she's a lot of trouble. Right? So you would have just allowed someone else to at least take her responsibilities more. That's what I mean. Eh? What is it now? Ibekwe? Where are you going to now, Ibekwe? Ibekwe, what is it? It's not that serious now. Are you not taking me home again? Ibekwe?
taking me home again? What is it now?
Now, welcome. Welcome enough. Madam, how village people now? Madam, is everything okay now?
Get out!
Sorry, madam. No good, madam.
Hello, barista. A very big fight. I just arrived at my compound now. Let's meet in my place tomorrow. 10 a.m. is fine. Alright.
Darling.
Oh dear. Come, sit.
Oh no, I am not that weak. What I can do. You're pensive. Well, I didn't know you were back.
I came in not too long ago. I met you sleeping. I didn't want to wake you up.
Yes, the medication knocks me out most of the time. Are you okay? It must be about your daughter.
Yes. They did not allow her to embrace me. They denied me access to my own child like I was some stranger.
That is wrong. They should have at least let you touch her, hold her, and even speak with her.
But I will contest it. They cannot deny me access to my own child. It's not possible.
Have you hired a lawyer yet?
Yes. She'll be here tomorrow.
Oh, good. Good. It's okay, darling. Come here. Come. Everything will just be fine, okay? Should be okay.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
Please sit.
Thank you again.
What can I offer you?
Oh, please, do not worry yourself. I'm fine. Thank you.
Okay. So, barista, like I briefed you over the phone, I left my daughter in the custody of her father, my ex-boyfriend. I want her back.
You want to file for her custody?
Yes, please.
It's okay, Mrs. Patra. I would need you to provide me with further details regarding this case. I need you to tell me everything about your daughter and the circumstances surrounding her.
I left my daughter with her father, my ex-boyfriend, and the mother when she was 6 months old. I needed to leave so I could secure a good future for the both of us. A future that even up to this moment, he could not and still cannot provide for us. Ibekwe is poor, very poor. with no prospect of breakthrough, at least not anytime soon. He cannot be able to give my daughter a sound education, a good exposure, and a secured future from that village.
It's okay, Mrs. Batra. We can build a strong case with everything you've said so far. All we need to do is lay emphasis on the fact that he is financially not capable to give your daughter the best of education and cannot as little as take proper care of her, leading to why custody of the child should be granted to you. We just need to lay emphasis on his finance and establish the fact that if you have custody of this child, she'll have the best of education, she'll be properly taken care of. And of course, the court always have the best interest of the child at heart, so we can work with that. However, I do have a question I would like to ask.
Okay.
Did he in any way pay your bride price?
No, not at all.
Perpetua, beautiful Perpetua. How are you now?
What is it?
Perpetua, see, I want us to be friends.
Friends? You want us to be friends? How? Why?
Perpetua, see, I've taken my time to think about everything that happened between us. I realized that I was the one wrong. I'm very sorry. Please, I came so that both of us can bond.
You don't mean it. That money my mother gave you that time, have you finished it?
Yes, so it has finished.
Don't mean it.
It has finished. Yes.
And now you want to make peace.
Yes.
Because you know that my mother is rich.
No, it's not like that. Far from that. I just want us to be friends. I want us to be, you know, in good terms so that we can
hope
be...
you make good use of that money my mother gave you. Because that is the last time my mother will give you money. Are you hearing me? She will not give you any money again. In fact, I'll be the one to control the way she spend that money. You see me? When I get there, I will control the way she spend that money. She will not give you any money again. So better go and make good use of that one.
Hey, Perpetua, I'm sorry now. Pepe, fine girl. Hi.
It is a war. It is a fight. Now who go carry Pepe? Now who go take you, Perpetua? I said it is a war. A very big fight. Now who go carry Pepe?
Yes, who is there? Who is there?
Yes, how may I help you?
Are you Mr. Ibekwe?
Yes, that is my name.
Ibekwe Ikowa.
Yes, what has my daughter done this time around? Eh? What has Amarachi done? What has she done?
My name is Mr. Madi. I'm the court bailiff. This is for you.
Court? Mama, what's a court?
Have a nice day.
Mama?
Huh?
Mama? Patricia sued us to court over Amarachi's custody.
What? Hey!
Patricia! Patricia! Okay. No problem. Okwa court! Patricia wants us to go to court. No problem. We'll go to court. Nso ba doro I get to court. Mama, don't panic. We'll go to court. Nso e wele onu. Patricia has nothing to say. We'll go to court, Mama. Don't worry. Okwa court. I get to court.
Yay! Omekwe. It never rains. It pours.
It is a war.
Yeah!
It is a fight.
Hey. Benji, why are you so in haste? What is pursuing you?
I'm hurrying to meet you at home before you leave. There is fire on the mountain.
I say fire, fire. What is it?
Report reaching me now is that our son Ibekwe and his baby mama Patricia are in contention of who gets custody of the child they have together.
Chelo, Chelo, you mean Amarachi?
Yes. And the worst part of it is that Patricia has sued him to court.
Chelo, without even bringing the case to Umunna to see how they can resolve it.
Oh. Mr. Robinson, we have to act fast before things get out of hand. Eh? That is why I'm here to see you.
I think what we have to do now is to fix a meeting immediately. Yes. Has anyone reached Robinson, Patricia's father?
I don't know.
Hey! Patricia, oh, hey!
Ibekwe should just let her take the girl. I mean, she's full of trouble already.
Exactly what I'm saying.
Contesting with Patricia in court will not favor him at all. And he doesn't have the resources to pursue the case at all.
Wait, oh, wait. Oh. People should not forget that Ibekwe took care of this girl. I think Ibekwe and the mother took care of this girl from when she was little, when she was an infant. And they have this bond together. It's not the mother coming out from nowhere and saying, it's my daughter, it's my daughter. Even if Ibekwe agrees to let that girl go, the mother that I know will not agree.
Nakaroine Ekwifa, I'm just asking myself if you're truly my friend. Just imagine what you're vomiting from your mouth. See, Ibekwe should let that Patricia or whatever take custody of her daughter. Then he should come and do the necessary thing, concentrate. Eh? Which one is this one? I beg.
Let's allow the court to decide that. Let's allow the court to
decide. The court will soon decide. You will hear.
Yes.
I better give
you
my
is your money, money, please. Let me go.
1,000.
Zoro,
give me bag. Mama Zoro, give
me. Give me bag, please.
Bag, no, they are back. They go. Wear it on your head. Style them, yes. Wear it on your head.
Wear it on your head now. Your wig is fine.
I've styled it already for you. Poor boy, you understand? It's good.
Lovina, when will you do one for me?
Mama, you're married wig. Me. Go and ask Patricia to do wig. You know, you're not going to cook. I'm not using my money to buy cook for you.
As we all know, it is no longer matter of if they sue, but now a matter of now that they have sued to take custody of our daughter, how do we go about it?
You have a very serious question here. Ibekwe, are you ready to give up the custody of your daughter?
I am not letting anybody take my daughter from me. I will fight for her custody with everything I have.
Well, Ibekwe, Ige Jikwe Anwayo, because this is a critical case. It's a very serious one. And the people we are dealing with are not dummies. They are intelligent people. So Ige Jikwe Anwayo.
Iche, there is no problem. Nsubwadero.
It's all right. The Patricia in question, did you pay any bride price on her head?
No, I did not.
If you go near, ever go hold them. Okay, let me ask you again. Did you take any item to her family to show them that you have a plan of marrying their daughter? Or do you have anybody that can bear witness of this thing that we are talking?
Yes. I went to her family with 2 bars of yam, with 2 gallons of nkwenu, 2 gallons of pine wine.
Did the father accept those items?
You people should live by compound.
No, wait. My friend is not jobless. He's an electrician.
Go on now. Patricia, come inside.
My friend is not
Mr.
jobless.
Mr. Benjamin, take this boy out of my compound.
My friend is an electrician.
You should go now.
Oh, Benji. Let us go.
Let's go.
My friend is not jobless. Let us go.
You are back.
Patricia, come back, please.
My friend is not jobless. He's an electrician.
No.
They chased her out of the house completely. We accepted her in. We fed her, took care of her until she put to bed. And when she put to bed, 6 months after, she abandoned her baby and left. I personally took care of that child until she is of age. Now suddenly, Patricia appears from nowhere and wants her child, in quotes, back. It's not fair.
That does not change the fact that she's the mother of that child.
And I am the father of the child.
We have to take this matter in a very because she has the legal right to claim that girl. If this matter is already in court. And we have to look at it with Uche Ndioke. I will advise us to settle this matter out of court.
Iche, anywhere you people want us to settle this case, we'll settle it there. What I know is that my daughter is not going anywhere. Nobody is taking her away from me. If you people want us to settle it in this house, we'll settle it. If you people decide to settle it in court, we'll go to court and settle it. Yes, Patricia left her daughter for 15 years. Now she came out from nowhere trying to claim Amarachi. It will not happen.
Everything is set for the hearing.
Good. Have they been served?
Yes, ma'am. I got confirmation of that today.
Okay. Is there anything you would like me to do?
Absolutely nothing. I mean, we have filed every necessary application. All we have to do now is wait for the hearing date.
It's okay. Let me know if there is anything you would like me to assist you with. Okay? I just want my child back. I can't wait to reunite us.
It's okay, Mrs. Patra. Like I said, I will do my best. I shall make sure you get your child back.
Thank you.
And if you don't mind, can I take my leave, please?
All right.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Same with you. Oh, baby.
I'm okay. At least I'm not dying today. When is the hearing?
A week from now. But you don't have to bother yourself about it. I will handle everything. Just concentrate on getting well for me.
No. I should be there for you as you fight to reclaim the custody of you, of our daughter.
Baby, it is not your fault, okay? Just focus on getting well. Focus on getting well for us.
It's okay.
A very big fight here. Now who go carry Pepe? Oh, yeah, Ozzy, I'm in a basin. Now, my baby.
Ibenne. Ibekwe. Ibekwe. This one you're sitting like this. What is happening now? This one you're sitting like this. Are you confused?
Court hearing is in a week time.
Hi.
Yes. And I'm yet to get a lawyer that will handle my case.
Now, Ibekwe, who did you tell? No, did you tell me?
If I told you.
Uh-huh.
How?
Ibekwe. You did not tell me. And you're just sitting like this thinking.
Owakwe, you and I know that I don't have any money to buy a lawyer. And one of them go lawyer. I don't have money.
You are still making it. The question I asked you was, who did you tell? No. Who did you tell? Huh?
Don't understand. Who did I tell? Owakwe, it's not like I'm looking down on you. But you know that I know your financial status. You don't have money. Yes, you don't have money now.
Okay.
But wait, Owakwe, did you win another bet that you didn't tell me? No, you know you are very trickish. Did you win another bet that you didn't tell me? Okay, no problem.
Mm.
Let's assume I did not tell you. Now I'm telling you.
Okay.
Owakwe, I don't have money to get a lawyer that will defend my case.
Okay. Ibeko, number one. You have already looked down on me, but I will forgive you. After all, you're my friend. Eh? Then secondly, Ibeko, let me now tell you. Will it shock you or surprise you if I told you I will help you?
You?
Uh-huh.
Help me?
Uh-huh.
Owakwe, jengon, kubiko,
Ibekwe, now, I want you to understand that this man standing before you or next to you is a lawyer in the making. I am not practicing, so you don't know. Secondly, my father happens to be a lawyer also. Just like two of us, we don't have chamber. So no need. Okay, but this is not our case now. I have a distant brother from my mother's side, who has been practicing law for over 10 years and now. His name is Barrister Tai.
Lawyer.
I will get him to stand in for you in court, free of charge. Ibekwe, why are you standing like this? Ibekwe, don't stand like this. Now, you know your heart is always intimidating
me. I need to hear you very well now. I need to hear you very well.
So you're not coming angrily?
Did you say you will get him to defend my case?
So you're not angry?
No, I'm not.
I will get him to defend your case, Ibekwe. You are my friend. What are friends for? For you, yes.
Owakwe, you said free of charge. But him and I know full about 10,000. I know. How much is it? I will still
give you. Understand, but Ibekwe, be calming down, though, because the way you're is like you want to swallow me. Calm down first. See, the only thing I will tell you now is, because it's transportation. Because I have to go to Ihioma. Then from Ihioma, I will now branch to Oboro. Then negotiate to Amifek. You know this is some. Then on the movement, I have to buy like gala and the Pepsi.
How much is it?
Let's just say, because 3,000 will be okay. Even if it's 3,000 will be okay. I don't know if you have. Because me, I don't have.
Okay. Hope he speaks well.
You don't know my cousin, no? I thought he's a distant cousin, not even close. Distant. You'll be surprised. 3,000.
This is it.
You should have added because.
Well, wait, you said 3,000 naira now.
Hey, but the one you're keeping, there's no need for.
Forget about this one. Wakwe, you need to help me, please.
I will get. You don't know my cousin, no? Speaks a lot of English. Let me go and get him so that by evening. He
speaks very well.
Relax. But that one, you should have given me that the remaining this year.
So your family have lawyer.
Even myself.
And your life is like this. Ha!
More than. Anyways, we have
thank
enough.
You very much. Hi. Chukumo Obeyo, Elokwaki Isialo. Thank you very much on this one. Ha! So now I can now drink water and rest.
It is a war.
Yes.
It is a fight.
Oh, okay.
Now who go carry the bag? Now who go take the perpetual?
Original! Original!
Where's this woman?
Original!
What's your apple?
Madam, give me.
Why are you shouting my name like that?
Where to?
That's one for you!
Madam! Hey! What's your apple? Please make you this. Hey! Bring the volume down, no verse. This is not FM, I've been ahead. What do you want? No verse. I came to take a bottle of beer. Now, so you will welcome me. Is this how you now welcome a customer?
Welcome customer, my foot.
Move your foot. Madam, I don't understand.
Okay.
Yeah?
Wait, ma, I tell you. I am not giving you a bottle of drink here. Remember, sir, you will earn me 5,000 naira. And if you not pay me that money for hand, no drink for you. I'm not going to serve you anything for here. Just carry on for mine.
My 5,000. That money na old one. I will pay you. Just leave the old one. Let us treat this one for now. Yeah? You know they read Bible. Bible talk and say, oh, this will pass away.
And now because say all things don't pass away. And a new one will they do. For that reason, pay me the old one. Make I serve you the new one. Period.
Madam, your blood they hold today, I go give you.
Begin bring her. I they wait.
You for just give me.
Oh, Akwe, give me my money. Hey. Give me my money.
I take my 3,000 there. Now give me his drink. Cold one. I beg. This is what you should be like saying now one papa bonus. Don't they do like this?
Now you know resemble for anywhere. At all, we no resemble.
You don't see the belly, you'll be like saying.
Not true.
No verse.
Which kind of thing be this? They swear for you.
Cold one, cold one. Oh? Original. Hi. You see, make a verse before. I mean, make a line, five bottles.
Mama, don't tell me that. Don't tell me that. Huh? Why will I hate her? Why will I hate her? Because your papa thinks she's a bad person.
She abandoned you for years.
Mm-hmm. Is she not back? Is she not back? She's back and she's my mother. You cannot change that fact.
All right.
Okay. I believe she's a bad person. What about you and papa?
Eh?
Have you been nice to me?
Oh.
Have you been nice to me? You both, have you been nice to me?
Amarachi, you know we love you. Eh? We cared for you until you are of age.
Mm.
We love you so much.
You don't mean it. You love me. And come on to call me by my baptismal name. You couldn't do that. I pleaded, I requested, I demanded you stop calling me Amarachi. But what did you do? You want to show me that you are wicked. You want to show me that I don't have any right to decide on what I want for myself. Anyway, if I were you, by now you just start petting me. Care for me, love me, papa me, pet me. Like, love me as if I'm your everything. Because my mother will soon come. And you know, I'm going with her. Nothing can change it.
My daughter, come. Perpetua, come. Hmm? Come, Pepe.
Go to your father. Hmm? Pepe.
It's me, your father, calling you. Come. Bia. Mwambia. Come now. Hmm? Come.
Pepe.
Come to your father. If you see the kind of dance I danced the day they gave birth to you, you will know that I love you so much and I can do anything for you. Eh? Okay. From today, I will not only call you the name Perpetua, but I will make sure everyone else call you that name, Perpetua. Okay. How about that? Mm-hmm.
Pepe.
Amadita, mm-hmm.
It's good though. Mm-hmm. Is this thing not simple now?
Very simple.
This is what I've been asking people since. It's simple now. Now that my mother is about to come and pick me now, you people are start choking me with love.
Oh. You know I love you so much. Eh? Perpetua, mom.
But are you sure you start doing it?
I'm very sure. I promise. Eh? Well, Perpetua.
Let's see how you keep your promise now.
I promise.
Let's see.
Pepe.
Because you know that very soon now, the judge will just ask me, are you going with your mother or your father? Me, I'll just say, I'm going with my mother. Hey. We'll just knock that thing. Boom. Touch your basa.
Perpetua.
Come now, my grandchild.
Come.
Go for energy, so
choking me with love now. This love is not too much. Oh.
My precious daughter.
Not too much.
We love you.
Perpetua.
Pepe.
Mwa daddy. Perpetua. Ibenem. Ibenem. We have landed. Where is anybody? Ikwenne.
It is a fight. Now who go carry Pepe?
Ibekwe. Come, we have landed. We have landed. This is what we call original landing. This is my cousin, Luminary.
Luminary.
Yes.
John is Luminary.
Ibekwe, I told you I will bring someone who will do this thing for you. Yes.
Ooh. Your cousin.
Yes, Mama, my cousin. Yes.
Mama.
His name is Barista Tai.
Barista Tai.
Yes.
My brother here has already told me about the lawsuit against you.
Yes.
In my magnanimity, I've decided to take up the case without pay.
Did you hear that? Magnanimity.
Okay.
He even told me about the closeness between both of you.
Friends.
That yes. Parallel existing between the two friendships.
Are you hearing me? Parallel.
So, and how important it is for you to retain the custody of your daughter.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much, Basta.
Barista Time.
Barista. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Baba, you don't need to worry yourself because he has said this is a small case. Ibekwe, you don't know this guy, you. See, let me tell you, this guy has handled cases like all these people. What is that there? Saddam Hussein. Barack, I'm sorry, not Obama. All those long names that came from outside. When they have serious cases, this guy goes and, in as much as there's this kind of, but he still participates well. Yes, I think.
You've said it all.
Oh, he's my listen.
Barista Tai.
Tai, yes, you're
sorry,
there.
In acronym. Tai. My full nomenclature is Barista Titus, the Esquire.
Oh, acronym. Okay. I said, let me ask you, don't be offended. But are you familiar with this kind of case? Udiribe Tukwaganya? What I mean is, have you handled this kind of case before?
This is you have nothing to worry. Mama,
how long have you been practicing law?
10 years. Yeah, it's been long, like 10 years.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I've had 66 cases.
Yes,
which 15 out of it you are criminal cases.
Okay. How many did you win?
I won.
Well,
I
say one.
Oh,
yay. And he later lost that one.
Hey! That is when it was appealed.
It's finished.
Okay.
Yeah.
But Ibn MC, let me tell you, don't let that one weigh you down. This guy here is good. Don't be disturbed though because of this one, because he has settled for one or two things. When I told him about your case, he now said, okay, fine. Yeah. This is his chance to come to the limelight. You understand? He is planning all the bomb because I told him everything. So don't worry yourself.
With my serious case.
You don't need to... you don't know Tayo.
I am out for it. Just leave it for me. I'll handle it adequately.
Come, let me see you for a second.
Nobody is a babe.
I'm an Oyibo Babara.
Forget that thing. See, this guy here is very intelligent too.
even without being told, look at the look on his face. He knows that you want to take me out to talk one or two things. See, Ibekwe, don't feel afraid. Don't be shaken by anything. See, let me tell you, this guy here is going to win. Ibekwe, see, I don't understand though. Okay, you we should go.
Wait. You know, this my case is a very serious case. Eh?
Look at you.
We have built our case on two grounds. First is on the premise that Ibekwe is poor and cannot adequately provide for your daughter Amarachi. Hence, it is not in Amarachi's best interest to remain in his custody. Again, we shall challenge the legitimacy of his claims to fatherhood since he has no claims to have married you customarily. But then again, Mrs. Patra, you shall come under some heavy fire for abandoning your infant child at such a young age. Now, I don't know who is representing them, but I know he or she is going to hold on to that and make a hell of a case out of it. Which is why our defense is that you regret it all. You were young and didn't know better, so you felt that was the best decision you could make at that point in time. Given the level of poverty Amarachi was born in, you had to leave to go secure a beautiful future for your daughter, which you have now returned to give it to your daughter Amarachi. With these solid points, things should turn out in our favor.
Barrister, do you think we will win this case?
Mrs. Patra, we are going to get your daughter back. Please, cheer up.
Thank you.
Tomorrow is the D-Day for the court hearing. I hope you will be there to support Ibekwe, physically and emotionally.
Honestly speaking, I don't know why Ibekwe is contesting this. I honestly don't know. He would have just allowed Perpetua's mother, take custody of her so that we can have time for each other.
Ibekwe, I know, will not allow that. Not without the court's order.
Court's order? Well, I'll be there. But I just pray he loses.
No, now. Allow the court to decide that.
Decide what exactly? Decide what?
Omo, this life is actually unbelievable. Can you imagine Amarachi Perpetua? The village terror, that troublesome child. Suddenly, she's now the interest of everyone.
Honestly.
See how she's now a valuable child. Everybody is trying to know what's going to happen in this her case. Do you know that Ibekwe announced in the town hall meeting that no one should be seen calling her Amarachi again?
I heard. I heard. But I pray and I know very well that he will lose this case.
He will lose. Is he not the one
he
that trained lose. That girl?
Trained
that the mother just came out
from
nowhere.
I just want him to myself. Not, those ones are not my business. I just want him to myself. Simple.
He will not lose.
Thank you.
May it please my lord, I am interested in suit number 7 in the cause list.
Call up the case clerk.
Suit number A/101/2023. Patricia Robinson Thompson, complainant.
Present.
And Mr. Ibekwe Ikuwa, defendant.
Present.
Milord, both parties are present in court.
Appearances.
My lord, I am OAE Okafor, and with me is ENS, representing the applicant.
Can you please, my lord? I am T.O. Ofume for the respondent.
You cannot sit down.
My lord, we are ready for our case. We have a witness in court.
Call in the witness.
Says my lord, are you a Christian, Muslim, or pagan?
Christian.
Then hold this verse and say after me. I swear by Almighty God.
I swear by Almighty God.
That evidence shall give in this case.
That evidence is given in this case.
Will be the truth.
Will be the truth.
The whole truth.
The whole truth.
And nothing but the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
My lord, PW1, swear on the Holy Bible and state in English language.
Mrs. Patra, can you tell this honorable court your name?
My name is Patricia, my lord.
Can you narrate your story to the honorable court?
My lord, life happens and we all have our different experiences. Ibekwe and I have a daughter together. Her name is Amarachi Perpetua. Ibekwe was poor and is even poorer and cannot obviously take care of my child. 15 years ago, I took in with the pregnancy of Amarachi. I saw hell in the hands of Ibekwe, as he could not feed himself, neither could he feed my baby and I. By the grace of God, on the 15th of March, 2008, I gave birth to Amarachi, my daughter. After giving birth, I saw hell again in the hands of Ibekwe, as he could not pay our hospital bills. I had to stay extra 4 days in the hospital. When I finally left the hospital, I told myself that I was going to go to the city to seek for greener pastures. So I left for the city so I could be able to take care of my daughter. Now I am back and I want my child back. Ibekwe has refused me access to my daughter. So I am pleading my honorable lord and the honorable court to please tell Ibekwe to give me my child. Thank you.
Are you telling this honorable court that there were nights you went to bed in pain and tears because your man could not provide food for you and your child?
Yes, you're right.
Are you also telling the court that you went to the city because you wanted greener pastures for your daughter?
Exactly, you're right.
Thank you, my lord.
Counsel, are you ready for the case?
My lord, we'll be asking for a short adjournment to enable us to prepare for the cross-examination.
It is a war. Hey! It is a fight. Now we go carry Pepe. Now we go take it, Pepe Chua. I said it is a war. A very big fight, yeah. Now who go carry Pepe?
You are not taking anything from this table or bucket until you tell me why you run out from the case. What kind of thing is that?
I don't understand you. How did I run out from the court? Huh? That was a legal tactical movement that I made.
I'm also able.
Huh? Didn't you see that when she was talking, I was busy putting down, writing down everything she was saying. So that when I come back home, I can just like just as we are home now, I can have a lot to prepare on my own to fire back.
Yeah.
When it's time for me to question her.
You know, my only happiness is that Patricia came with a little female lawyer.
Huh?
Yes. So me, I believe we'll win the case.
Ibekwe. Fear those little ones or those small ones, those small sizes.
Okay.
Ibekwe, those people can be poisonous and dangerous.
Eh?
You understand? The way they will attack you from under, pam, before you know it, they're on top of you. Fear those people. You understand? Now that you that is saying you did not run away. That time that girl was speaking big English, blowing long English. Why did you not stand up and say
objection?
Why you left her? She was saying you don't object.
Listen, one thing at a time. You don't rush these things. It was her own time to lie, to talk, to do anything she wants to do. That is why I seek for an adjournment so that we can come back home, layers. Work on those lies, all those things she said.
Mm.
You can prepare for it go back.
You're keeping her like Jackie Chan. You're going for an attack.
That's not what you are going for.
Uh-huh. Stop that thing, but we are not yet done.
What again now?
Hmm.
You want to eat this thing?
Imagine.
You want to eat corn.
Barrister Tai, this one, they allowed only Patricia to be talking. They did not even give me a little time for me to say my own side of the story. The next thing they said, the case has been adjourned, that we should go. Am I not going to say my own side of the story? Because I have a lot of things to tell our judge.
I'm going to scrutinize her, cross-examine her, and get factual facts from her. Even from all these are useless lies. I know you don't understand what I'm saying. Just the way we are home now. We are just building up our own amore against her in the law court.
Mm.
We will go back there. Ibekwe, once I'm done with her, it will be your turn to talk.
Okay. Shebi then say make we go court. Okwasekaije court. We go the go court. Patricia, I am coming for you.
See.
Ibekwe, okay. I like the way you're standing. You're standing bold. You have confidence. But you see that man, that man that is up there, that have white beards.
That's the chief judge.
Ibekwe, that man's face. Ibekwe, don't joke with such people. Ibekwe, in life, anyone whose face is more uglier than my own, Ibekwe, give that person respect to they have bad mind.
Uh-huh.
You see that man? Ha. In court, if you, okay, you're not paying attention to me. Anytime I'm looking that direction, that man turns to look at my side. Ibekwe, I'll remove my face first. Because this man can just look at my face and decide to give me urgent 2 years or 3 years imprisonment.
Eh?
I'm telling you now, you know I have this face. You understand? Don't talk anyhow in that court.
So you mean he's going to give me urgent 3 years
imprisonment? No, now Ibekwe, not you. Your face is okay now. Don't look at my face now. That is the problem. That is you don't joke with. You understand? Because me, I know what I'm saying. You understand? Please, don't talk in here. You, now that we are certain that you have plans, you can now go ahead with the combo. Don't take the long one, or take the short one. Careful on the right side. No, now take the other one.
Okwakot, Patricia, I'm coming for you.
Then
leave this call. Let us talk. We need to plan. Let us know the way forward. Leave the con for the for our barrister.
But what do you want to plan now? Because all these things that you're planning, there's no way that we can
leave con. Leave corn. Allow him to eat.
Because allow him to eat.
You need to know the way forward.
What's the way forward?
Now.
Ibekwe.
How are we going to eat? Allow him to eat.
But he's eating the corn alone.
You have to prepare for this.
Okay, we'll put effort.
Oh.
Why did the barrister demand for an adjournment? What do you think he wants to do? Do you think he wants to make... Do you think...
Mrs. Patra, you need to calm down. We've just gotten started with the case, and the wise thing to do is not to worry your head on and on about the chances we have. All we can do right now is to watch how things unfold while actually preparing ourselves.
Which is why I will have to take my leave. I need to go and work for the next hearing.
Thank you.
Thank you.
In the meantime, I ask that you please not overwhelm yourself. This will turn out well. I am positive, and I need you to be. All right?
Thank you.
Good.
I have to go. Thank you very much.
Oh, good afternoon, sir.
How are you, barrister?
I am well, thank you.
I can see you're set to leave.
Exactly. Thank you.
Okay.
Have a great day, sir.
You too. Sorry, I couldn't come with you to the court.
It's okay. You need to get well. You don't need to stress yourself. Don't worry about the case.
But what are your chances?
Hopeful.
I don't know how long I have left to leave. The doctor said it could be any time. So that's why I want you to go about it. I mean about the custody of your child. So I can formally adopt her.
Sweetheart, you're not going to die. I will get back my child and we shall live happily. My only regret is I am not able to give you a child of your own.
You and I know that it has not been your fault that we couldn't have children. I married you because I do not want to die a lonely man. And you've been taking very good care of me. I need you to get the custody of your baby. Unfortunately, we cannot have children together. So just go ahead and get the custody of your baby.
Don't worry. I'm very optimistic I'll get back my child. Your lover.
I hope I live as long.
Mrs. Patricia, how old is your daughter?
15 years. 10 months and 7 days old today.
At what age did you abandon her?
Objection, my lord. Counsel is giving his opinion with the word abandoning. I strongly object to his framing of the question with the word abandon.
Objection sustained. Counsel, could you please reframe your words without using the word abandon?
Thank you, my lord.
Thank you, your honor. Mrs. Patricia, how old was your daughter when you left her without looking back?
6 months.
Sorry, I can't hear you. Can you please speak to the hearing of the court?
6 months.
6 months old. Her daughter was 6 months old when she abandoned her.
Objection, my lord.
I think the word abandon hurts, but she left. So let me ask you, Mrs. Patricia. Do you really love your daughter?
Of course, I love my daughter so much.
So much that you attempted not once but twice to kill her.
Objection, my lord. Question is speculative.
No, your honor.
Let me rephrase. Did you not try to abort the baby when you were pregnant? I mean the child we are talking about today, when she was still forming in your womb as a fetus. Sorry, I can't hear you.
No, I didn't.
Of course, I know you deny it, but that was your first attempt. Now let me ask you again. Aside breast milk, what other food substance was your daughter surviving on as at the time you abandoned her? Or sorry, as at the time you left? Please answer the question. At that age, what else was your daughter feeding on as at the time you left? Your Honor, I take a silence to mean no.
You have to answer the question.
She wasn't feeding on anything.
Now, I think your intention was to stop her today.
No.
No further questions, Your Honor.
My name is Ibeku Onowa. Patricia used to be my girlfriend. Along the line, I got her pregnant out of wedlock. My family and I made every necessary arrangement to pay for her bride price. But her parents rejected me. They humiliated me. She even wanted to terminate the baby, of which I pleaded with her not to. Simply because they said that I'm a poor man. Please, I want this honorable court to look at me very well. I am not a poor man, and I will never be poor. And I'm not in any way disabled. I work so hard as a man. I'm an electrician, doubled as a transporter. I love my daughter Amarachi so much. She's so precious to me like the air I breathe. That is why when her mother bailed out on her, I stayed. I was in pain. Even in my pains, I was still grinding. I was still working hard to take good care of her when her mother abandoned her without looking back. Patricia abandoned her daughter when she was barely 6 months old. She abandoned her without looking back. Oh, now it's over 15 years plus. She came out from nowhere claiming that she loves and cares for the same daughter she abandoned. No, now, this same Patricia Nka, this same Patricia, oh, abandoned a baby who depended 100% on her breast milk to survive. Patricia, I put it to you that you are a very wicked woman. You are so wicked and callous. You left your daughter to die, but I took the responsibility. I made sure that I nursed her from when she was small to this present age. Patricia is not worthy to be a mother. She is not worthy to be anybody's mother, and she should not be allowed to claim custody of any child. Thank you very much.
Cross-examination.
Thank you, my lord. Mr. Ibekwe, you have a beautiful daughter, am I correct?
Yes, her name is Amarachi Ibekwe.
Good. Are you proud to have her as your daughter?
Yes, I'm very proud.
Are you aware that fatherhood comes with a lot of commitments and responsibilities?
Objection, Your Honor. Questions lack relevance.
Relevance will be established in a moment, my lord.
Overruled. Answer the question.
Yes, I'm aware.
So then, would you say you have fulfilled every fundamental responsibilities required of a legitimate father?
Objection, my lord. Question is vague and lack specific.
Sustained. Go straight to the point.
Thank you, my lord. Mr. Ibekwe, Are you married to Mrs. Patra?
No, over my dead body.
Were you married to her at any given point in time?
Never.
In other words, you have not as little as paid her bride price, correct?
Objection, my lord. My client has already answered all these questions. He has never and was never married to Mrs. Patra.
Objection sustained.
So then you are the natural father of the child, but clearly lack legitimate claim of fatherhood.
Objection, your honor. The question is unfair and prejudicial.
It wasn't even a question. Actually, I will now proceed to ask my question. Mr. Ibekwe, how well did you cater for your then girlfriend at the time she was pregnant? And how well did you cater for herself and the baby after she put to birth?
To the best of my ability.
To the best of your ability?
Yes, I did.
How good was the best of your ability at the time?
Objection, your honor. Question is vague and less specific.
Counsel, please, can you ask specifics?
Thank you, my lord. Mr. Ibekwe, can you tell the honorable court why you did not get married to Mrs. Patra at the time you two were in love?
Objection, your honor. We are not seeking to unite them.
Overruled. Answer the question.
I went to her house with my people, Ndomo Nam. Her father is here. You can ask him. We went there to pay for her bride price with my tubers of yam, my keg of palm wine. But they pushed us away. They said that we should go, even with their daughter. They sent all of us out, that I'm a poor man, which I know I'm not.
Oh, they did? Did they reject you because you were poor?
Objection, your honor. Counsel is speculating.
Counsel, do you have further questions or do you still want to speculate?
That will be all for the witness, my lord. Thank you.
Mr. Ibekwe, can you tell this honorable court when you started taking care and full responsibility of your daughter?
From the moment I was informed that she has conceived.
All right. During the period of her pregnancy, where was she staying and who was taking care of her?
She was living under my roof. I provided for her and my unborn child. On a daily basis, I kept on buying jollof rice and chicken, akara yoko and bread, local sandwich, shawarma. I'm telling you, this is what I kept on buying every day. I never allowed her to do anything when she was pregnant. I was doing the washing myself. This Patricia, here I go, I did everything for her. But look at what she did to me. She left an infant baby, 6 months old, for a man like me to take care of. No, now, you people should reason this thing. Check it, it's not good. Odema now, it's not good.
Mr. Ibekwe, outside shelter and feeding, which other way did you take care of her during the period of this pregnancy?
I paid for the antenatal. Nobody gave me shisha. 1 naira, wolo nye nye mbiya.
When the child was born, who paid for the hospital
bill? I did. I even paid for the keke that brought her back home.
No further questions, your honor.
That will be enough for today.
It is a war. It is a fight. Now who go carry Pepe? Now who go take Pepe to her?
I said it. I almost admitted to the hearing of everyone that I attempted to abort my child. I backed out.
It's okay, but are you good now?
I'm not sure, barrister. I'm not sure.
You are not sure? You're not sure you want your daughter back?
Of course I want my daughter back.
Good. Then focus on how to get your daughter back and forget about every other thing. I mean, it's about your daughter, right?
Barrister.
Yes.
What's my fate? Are you sure we're going to win this suit?
I have no doubts. We will win.
Barrister, please ensure we'll win this case. Please.
It's okay, Mrs. Patricia. I shall do my best. Do not overwhelm yourself. This will turn out in your favor. Right? No more tears.
Ichiabenji, this case looks favorable to Idekwe.
Yes. I don't know where he got that lawyer from. That guy is really good.
You know, my surprise about that young man is that he does not have a look, you know, of somebody who can save someone. Talk of winning a case.
But he is very intelligent. He really surprised everybody today. I can't wait for the next hearing.
The next hearing is here. Papa, just next week. Oh. Orugo de Eluna.
Orugo. That boy is good.
Hey.
Mrs. Patra, can you, for the record, tell this honorable court why you left Mr. Ibekwe's house?
I left Mr. Ibekwe because he was poor. Not necessarily because he was poor, but because I didn't see him having a mindset of breaking through from poverty.
Objection, my lord. Witness is speculating.
My lord, just a moment and we shall prove this is no speculation.
Overruled. Go on.
Thank you, my lord. Mrs. Patra, how would you describe the days you lived with Mr. Ibekwe?
Very horrible.
Horrible. How did you know he was poor?
I lived with him. We lacked every basic amenities, which most importantly is food. I barely ate. As a nursing mother, my breast milk dried up because of lack of food due to malnutrition.
She's lying, you know. She's lying, you know.
Ibekwe, calm down.
George, oh, she's lying, you know,
Ibekwe,
mama.
Ibekwe, can you please calm down?
Okay.
Ibekwe, you need to comport yourself. I will not take this again. Go on.
That was 15 years ago. How did you know he lacks the prospect to break through from poverty?
Because I've had conversations with him, I've listened to him talk, I've listened to him pour out his mind. I don't see any prospect of wealth in him. I don't think he hungers for good life. 15 years later, it turned out I was right. When I came to search for my child, I met him in a house he inherited from his parents. Dilapidated building. He could not even renovate it. Same piece of furniture I saw 15 years ago was the same piece of furniture I met when I came back.
Okay, back to why you left. Can you tell this honorable court why you left behind your infant child?
Can I have a moment, please?
As difficult as it is, Mrs. Patra, you would have to speak so the court can hear you out.
No mother should experience what I went through in the hands of Ibekwe. Like I said, my breast milk dried up because there was no food to eat. There was no food to feed my baby. Each time I complain, he'll tell me to manage.
Manage what exactly?
To drink lots of water. So I thought about the whole thing. And the more I thought about it, the more I arrived at nothing. So I made up my mind to leave, even if I knew it wasn't the best decision.
Why is that?
I said it wasn't the best decision because staying in a house would complicate things. Because like I said, I fed my baby up to 6 months and there was no breast milk for my baby to drink. And he insisted on exclusive breastfeeding. And the only way you can give your baby good milk is when you are perfectly and completely fed. And that I wasn't having for me, Bekwe, because there was no food at all in the house. And secondly, I felt since his mother lives with us, she's experienced as a mother, she can be able to take care of my child on my behalf. And it will also be a less burden for Ibekwe since he's financially incapable. So I made up my mind to leave.
I know I can't take this. This woman is lying. Why now, baby man? Mama, this woman is lying. Hey,
please, calm
all
down.
All of this never happened.
Calm down.
George, you didn't hear
me.
This woman is lying.
Please calm down.
Uswewolowolu, she don't know what to say.
Attention, my lord.
You are a liar. You are a liar.
Uswewolowolu.
Big lady. You are a liar.
This absolute
big lady. Big lady.
Would they have released my son? Eh? I will not go here without him. We all die here. I'm not living here.
Ogechi, don't worry yourself. He shall be released. The MIC is simply not happy with the conduct of Ibebe. Eh? Barrister Tai must secure his bed, but he must comport himself better than this.
Yeah, better, because I'm not leaving here.
You see, yes, he lost his temper. Quite all right. But honestly, who would not? We all know it did not get that bad to an extent that her breast milk gets dry.
All lies.
This is a big lie from the pit of hell.
All lies. All lies. Huh? All they do here is lie.
Ashiashi.
Hey! Ashiwakwa. No. Eh? How can they say that? Eh? Bow. All I know, I'm not living here. I'm not living without my son. I'm not living. No.
Here they come.
Hey! My son!
Hey! These people are liars.
Hi! Hey.
Hmm? Barrister.
Barrister Tai? Meka. Hey! Katari here. Katari here.
Hey, Patricia. She's a big liar.
How can they say that her breast dried because of starvation and malnutrition in my own house? Hey!
These people are liars.
Only lies, is there? The only thing you know here is
lies. Mama, he only fell into their trap.
Oh.
They only want him to exhibit anger and violence before the magistrate.
Yes!
Hey!
They want the magistrate to see him as an angry man. So let's just go. So we can go and prepare.
Thank you for securing her.
Uncle Benji, I'm not giving out my daughter to anybody. It will not happen. It will not.
Barrister Tai, everything here is lie. All they know is lie. Oh, my son. You know, we must get her. We must get her. Hi. Barrister Tai. Hi, thank you. Hi. Oh, yeah, Patari.
Patricia, what are you doing here? I said, what do you want?
Why do you keep asking me questions like you have what I want? I'm here to see my daughter.
You are here to see your daughter? Which daughter are you talking about? Are you not shameless? The same daughter you abandoned many years ago. Oh, I thought we were in the court. Apart from your breast milk drying up, which other lies do you have to tell to deceive the judge?
Oh, please give me a break. What are you claiming? Super dad? You're only a father by accident. You have no legitimacy to fatherhood. Ain't you ashamed of yourself? Pay a bride price. Marry a woman the right way, then you can stand tall and talk like other men when it comes to fatherhood. But until then, shut your freaking mouth.
Well, I have no idea which daughter you mean or where she is. I don't even know what you are talking about.
You don't know what I'm talking about.
Yes, I don't know what you're talking about.
Where is Amarachi? She's my daughter.
You're welcome to go in and look for her. I have no idea the daughter you are looking for.
Amarachi.
Go and search for her. Shut your freaking mouth. You may go on a rape Selinak, Patricia.
Amarachi.
Do you know how much they sell Selinak?
Amara.
I left your daughter for 15 good years.
Amarachi. Amara. Amarachi. Amara. Ibeke, where's my daughter? Where did you keep her? Where is she?
Which daughter? Eh? Patricia, which daughter? I put it to you that you are not a mother. Yes, Patricia, you are not a mother. Okwesika Ejebe court. Let us go to the court now. Why are you scared? You have to wait for the final judgment. You are here telling me where is your... Leave my house, oh!
Okay, Ibeke. It's okay, it's not fair. I'm her mother. Mm. Let me see her, please. Stop keeping her away from me.
Which mother?
Please.
Patricia, may go around and raise her like. Do you know how much they sell baby food?
Okay, I'm sorry now. Just let me see Amara. I beg you.
Patricia, leave my house, oh! Leave my house! Huh. See that bempo? She got a bempo? Pokan can you fix the eyelashes?
Good afternoon, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you, ma.
I hope you are now friends with my daughter.
Yes, ma, we are now friends, ma.
Nice. Okay, I would like to get some information from you concerning my daughter and her father.
What kind of information, ma?
How badly has Ibeke been treating my daughter?
Ma, badly. Ma. Mr. Ibeke has not been treating her badly. It said it's even your daughter has been troubling Mr. Ibeke.
My daughter troubling Ibeke?
Yes, ma. In this village, it used to be one day, one problem. All caused by your daughter, ma. It's either she's beating up someone in the village, or she's flogging an elderly woman, or she's even having issues with her teachers challenging them.
My goodness. How is she able to do all of that?
Ma, it's she and some thugs she used to work with in this village that flocks around her, Uju and Chinaza. They cause problems everywhere and every time, and it all lands on Mazi Bekwe's head. The other day, Seth, I was even a victim. They beat me up because she does not allow people to call her her name or her real name, Amarachi. She will tell you that if you call her Amarachi, that she's going to deal with you. So she prefers people calling her Perpetua. And anybody that calls her Amarachi, the person becomes the scapegoat, is the person they would deal with in this village. I was going after them one by one in my own case. So it was her turn before I now met you. At Ibeke's compound.
Strange. So, when last did you see her?
I saw her yesterday, she and her grandma.
Because I'm just coming from their house, she's not at home.
They were going for a ceremony at the grandmother's place.
Oh. Okay. Anyways, thanks for the information. Where were you heading to?
To my friend's shop, ma.
Let me drop you off.
Thank you, ma. Thank you.
It is a war. It is a fight. Now who go carry pepper? Now who go take pepper? You are. I said it is a war. A very big fight, yeah. Now who go carry me?
I've listened carefully and I've weighed the facts and options before me. I would like to state that the position of this court is to make sure the girl's interest is prioritized. You, Mr. Ibekwe, have lived a good part of your life. So have you, Mrs. Petra. But this little girl has her whole life before her. Hence, in my judgment, reasons supersede emotions and facts over sentiments. Now my judgment. The court found that Mr. Ibekwe lacks legitimacy of fatherhood as he is not legally married to Mrs. Petra, the mother of the child. He, however, retains status as a natural father. It's also the position of the court that Mr. Ibekwe has not satisfied the court on a financial position that will enable him to provide and cater for the child in question. Furthermore, the court finds that Mrs. Petra did not abandon her daughter, but only left to go and secure her future. The court holds that Mrs. Petra is in a better financial position to provide for their daughter, hence denying her the custody of the child and allowing Mr. Ibekwe to continue having custody of the little girl is not in her best interest. Therefore, the court has granted application of Mrs. Petra Okezie to have full custody of their daughter, Ms. Amarachi Perpetua Ipo.
No, I won't take it! I won't take it! This is nonsense! Patricia is a liar! She's a concrete liar! She's a liar, George! And I will not take it! Mama, it is not possible! I will not take it! You think you can come here and frame things up? It will not work! Patricia, it will not work! Uwakwe? Uwakwe? It will not work! It will not work! Don't take my daughter from me! No! Don't take my daughter from me! Don't!
Ibekwe.
Hey! Hey! Mama!
What is it?
Mama! Mama, I was dreaming, you know? It was a dream! Hey!
Why won't you be dreaming when you're here sleeping at this time of the day when your mates are out there hustling?
Hey! Mama!
Hmm?
Mama, they took my daughter from me.
To Fiakwa.
Patricia won the case.
Mm-mm. Nobody is going to take my granddaughter away. Ah, not after all these years. Mm-mm.
But Mama, they did. I saw them.
Ibekwe. Werewayo, hmm? Calm down. You better push out all these your negative thoughts, all these fears. Put them out. Tomorrow is another hearing day. We will win. Take it easy. Take it easy on yourself. Where do you want
we are going to win this case, oh.
We will. Eh?
We must win this case.
We will, by God's grace.
They won't take my daughter from me.
They will not.
It will not happen.
Where do you want Is it?
I told you that Patricia has bribed that judge. Judge Erico, Erico bribe. I saw it clearly in my dream. It was very clear. I told you that they will snatch my daughter away from me. Then look at it. Is it not happening? Or why bribe? Go judge. They have collected my daughter from me. I saw it, I told you. It's him not Eba. The hunger is disturbing me, malaria. Then look at it.
Ibeke, calm down. Ibeke, calm down first. It's not like this.
My problem. Just because you don't have money.
Mama, forget about this money. Money. Money will come. Oh.
Mama. Mama, let's just calm down. Eh?
Mama. Mama, stop crying.
Eh? Stop crying. You know the judge has not given his final ruling. Amrachi only has 2 weeks to spend with Patricia. Just stop crying.
Barrister, didn't you hear all those lavishing packages?
Mama,
she told the judge that she has put in place for Amarachi. Barrister, die with that. We've lost her custody.
We've not lost anything. Patricia!
We've
not lost anything.
Patricia has humiliated my entire family. She rubbed it on our faces that we don't have money. Naibu Obiamo! Obe Onunto! Did you hear all the things? She said she already made arrangement for Amarachi. That she already secured admission for her in one of the best schools in this state. That she already bought a trust fund, which as you know, $6,000 is already in it. Huh? All the things that she know I cannot afford. Nenu Patricia, doing in dollars.
Just calm down, eh?
Ordinary Patricia.
Hey!
Okay.
Is that all? I've lost my granddaughter.
Mama.
All these years.
Mama, this case has been adjourned in 3 weeks' time. We've not lost her. Amarachi is just with her for 2 weeks. She'll be back before the court sitting day. So why are you lamenting?
Barrister Tai! Didn't you see all the things they were playing in that court? Didn't you see that the judge has been bribed?
This is law.
Go bribe now.
Ibeko, this is law. Can you please calm down? Huh? We've not lost the case. Just calm down. You're still going back to court in 3 weeks' time. Amarachi just have 2 weeks to spend with Patricia.
But Tai, please, you know you're my cousin. I want to understand something. Because inside that court, you were saying something like something. Mm. You know, when you say those things, I thought from the look of things that we have won this case, that we are coming back home with Amarachi. But now, as it looks, it's like that thing is meaningless.
Can we please just give ourselves some time? We are going back to court in 3 weeks' time. Please!
Now, Higgy Demodis.
Hey!
Higgy Higgy.
Sir, sweeping a terror on Anchi.
That man there without
Patricia, be a yako! A yako ko be big man! She was just busy telling lies!
That man is like a masquerade, though. That one would have white beard, long one. The main one.
George Lee Bryan.
He's like a masquerade.
I told my mother. I saw it in my dream. Koro. But that's not hunger. Because I'm a poor man now. Everything is that hunger.
After all the
okay.
Brother,
you are not poor. Just stop lamenting.
I'm not poor.
Ana benneya. Hey! It's all of you like this. Did anybody die? Are you mourning anybody? Mama, who died? Oh, is it because of me? It's just 2 weeks now. I'll be coming back very soon. It's just 2 weeks. Papa, come and help me now. Don't worry, it's 2 weeks, yeah? Calm down. Don't cry. I'm coming back. It's 2 weeks. It's just 2 weeks. Let the poor breathe. Do not suffocate them. Let me go and breathe fresh air in the city. I'll come back. Wow! This place is so fine. Wait, you mean you live here?
Mm-hmm.
You sleep here, you wake up here every day.
Obviously.
Henceforth, you will also be sleeping and waking up here every day.
Wow. Hey! Dad, George, Chibi, you said it's 2 weeks I will stay here only. I'm asking no, because it's like this time around, he will do his worst. Because me, I cannot enjoy all these things finish and go back to the village. I cannot do it. Because those village people, they used to see me as a bad person. So I cannot do it. After all, me, I'm a small pikin. They cannot arrest me.
Rebecca, it's okay. Come and freshen up. We can worry about that later, okay? Come, let's go.
Please, one more thing. It's very, very important. That your gate man, I beg, help me beg him. Let him be respecting me. Because you are my mother and you are the one that owns this house. So me too, I'm the owner of this house. I'm also the madam in this house. He should be calling me Miss Perpetua.
Okay. Anything you want, I'll do it for you.
Okay.
Perpetua, I don't know why you always go for things bigger than you.
Yeah, no problem.
Let's go.
You can bath. Okay. Save you. You cannot carry it. Let me carry it.
Save your small power.
Hey! Grandpa! Grandpa!
Darling.
Yafa! Grandpa, sir! Good evening, sir! I'm fine, sir. Grandpa, Kai! Your grandfather is still alive. Wow! You don't know that all these people in the village, before they will grow and marry, your grandfather will die.
Perpetua! It's okay. It's okay. Let's go.
Hey, you're lucky.
Shut up.
So you're trying to tell me that you haven't visited Ibekwe since the last court hearing?
My dear, I haven't. I haven't. I don't think this is the right time for me to make my move.
I don't understand. What are you talking about? This is the right time for you to make your move. Especially now that he's still hot over the court's decision. This is the best time for you to make your moves.
But I think he's still grieving.
Grieving on what? Grieving over what? Eh? Did you lose someone? Is it not just that he lost custody of his daughter? Not like the girl is dead per se. So this is the best time for you to shoot your shot.
But he has never invited me to his house. And he hasn't introduced me to the mother either. I don't think it's right to go to his house uninvited.
If he has not invited you to the house, you invite yourself. Introduce yourself to the mother. That is it. The only reason why Ibekwe has not invited you to the house or introduced you to the mom is because of that winch Amarachi.
Did you just call her Amarachi?
I mean Perpetua, Miss Perpetua. But all I'm saying is, go and visit Ibekwe. If possible, sleep over.
B?
Yes.
I think you have a point here.
Now, I've never given you the wrong advice before. I have a point.
Let me quickly lock my shop. Let me start going in.
Let's go. Come and carry your chair.
Help me and carry. Just drop it here. Let me just lock.
She be troublemaker number one. I'm a rachi pepe chua.
This is just the beginning. By the time I'll be done with you, since you have refused to show me where my mother is, you have refused to tell me who she is, you have refused to take me to my mother, I got Peria.
Hey! I got Peria.
Part one. Let me tell you something you don't know. There is no peace for the wicked. If you don't take me to my mother, there won't be peace for you in the south.
Hey.
Yes.
If I don't take you to... Anumano. Mama, we were actually wrong.
What are you talking about?
All she wanted was to be addressed as Perpetua and to be told about her mother. Rather than reason with her, we totally disregard her. That made her turned rebellious and troublesome. Because nobody cared about her concerns. And we concluded that she was possessed. No so no too. It's all our fault. Our fault, why?
And all the spiritualists you visited, they almost said the same thing, trying to warn us, but we failed to understand.
Hi. Had I known, all these things wouldn't have happened. Had I known.
Always come at last.
Hi.
Good afternoon, Mama.
Afternoon, Mom.
Ibeko, good afternoon. How are you?
I'm fine.
I just came to check up on you because I've not really seen you after the court very. So I want to know how you're
doing. Ah. Okay. You know, okay, now look at me. Eh? Ah. Mama Nkena Adokwara. Her name is Lovina. The girl I told you about.
Oh. Lovina, ma.
Ma. Thank you, ma.
Welcome, ma.
Thank you.
Ah, come and sit down.
Don't worry, let me sit here.
Oh, anakagem ma. Dona wa. Dona wa. Oh, dona. No. No. Ah, I'm Papa, no.
It's okay.
I don't get joy.
I understand. Don't worry. Everything will be fine. Hmm?
Hi. My Papa.
It's okay. So how are you?
Mommy. Good morning.
Good morning, my baby. How are you?
I'm fine.
I hope you had a sound sleep.
Yes. I feel like I'm in paradise.
Really?
Yes.
I'm glad you enjoyed your sleep.
Yes.
Breakfast is set. Go and eat.
Okay. What should I address him as?
Daddy.
Daddy.
Good morning, Perpetual.
Daddy.
You can address me as Mr. Thompson.
Mr. Thompson, good morning. Well, Mr. Thompson.
Don't say a word. Go and eat. Your food is getting cold.
Okay.
Your daughter is too hilarious for her age.
She's a handful. What is it?
Tea, every day.
Okay, you know, some people take tea with toasted bread and boiled eggs. Some use fried eggs. If you don't like it, there's bread and butter. You can have that one.
I'm talking about tea. You're telling me bread and butter. I don't want tea now. You can't we take like strong food in the morning? Strong food.
Strong food like what?
Like apple, akara, akara and bread. Akamu, beans, all these, you know what I mean.
But Perpetual, this tea and bread you're having is better than these things you just mentioned.
No. Me, I want akpo because since I came here, I've not eaten akpo.
Okay. I'll get you akpo. What soup do you want?
Oha soup.
Oha soup. Don't worry, I'll get it for you. Go and eat, your food is getting cold. Okay, go and manage that one. I'll tell Friday to get you akpu and oha soup. You have it for lunch.
Okay. After eating this, I'll see that boo.
No problems.
Open the gate, I want to go out.
Ma?
Who is Ma? Do I look like your mother? How many times have I warned you to stop addressing me as Ma? Call me Miss Perpetua. Are you deaf?
Sorry, Miss Perpetua.
Hey, better. Miss Perpetua. Go open the gate, let me go out.
Ah, Miss Perpetua, I beg you get with you one by far outside, I beg. Make you tell big madam, I beg. She go other than for you, I beg.
Are you mad? Are you mad? Must I report myself, like, must I explain myself to you before you do what I ask you? In fact, go and open that, or I'll make you lose your job. Now!
Ah, my job? I beg, sorry. Ah, come, I open gate for you, I beg.
Ogboro. Did you like all day?
Honey, food is ready.
Okay.
I made fufu.
Are you kidding me?
I know. I made your favorite weeds. Let me get Perpetua so we can eat together.
All right, darling.
Perpetua! 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 Peppy! Perpetua! Honey, did you see Perpetua leave this house?
No. Why are you asking?
I can't find her.
Have you checked her room?
She's not there.
Oh, okay. Maybe our room. Check outside. Anywhere in the compound.
Perpetua! Perpetua! Friday!
Perpetua!
Did you see my daughter? I can't find her.
Miss Perpetua?
Is there any other daughter I have in this compound that you know? Did you? I can't find her. Where is she?
Madam, she come out.
What?
What do you mean by she come out?
She said make her open gate for her, say she won't go outside.
And you allowed her?
She said if I no open gate, say she will make sure make you sack me, madam.
Hey!
How long ago was that?
2 hours ago, sir.
Hey! Hey, please, what?
I've allowed her to go.
Hey, my goodness.
Where would this girl go? Where is Perpetua? Where is she?
Perpetua!
She's not in the car.
DPO, I know. You know how it is. Huh? Please do everything in your power to find our daughter, please. Okay? Lupio, thank you. Please keep us updated on every progress, please.
DPO, please help me find my daughter. Please do everything you can to find her. I'm begging you in the name of God, please.
Calm down. Darling, please calm down.
Madam, I beg you, madam, see him.
Are you stupid? Go down on your nails.
Sorry, ma'am. Madam, I beg you. Madam, I try. I try to stop her, but she says if I no open gate, say she will sack me. Madam, I
beg. Why did you alert me? You know she just got in here and she's not familiar with the environment. And you let her go out? Are you that dumb? Are you stupid?
Madam, I beg. I beg. I swear, no go happen again.
I just feel like strangling you to death right now.
Darling, it's okay. It's okay. Please calm down.
Look, just pray nothing happens to that girl. Because if anything happens to her, you will have me to contend with.
Darling, I am sure the police are on it. They will find her. Alright? You go back to your duty
post. Thank you, sir.
Which duty post? Go and search for her everywhere! Leave the compound and go out! Make sure you bring her back!
Darling, come on. It's okay. It's okay.
Ms. Robinson, thank you once again for your audience. We have come in peace and for peace. The route to peace is usually longer, but it is worth it. We are kinsmen, and we shouldn't have dragged each other to court in the first place without trying to resolve the problem within ourselves. But be it as it may, we have retraced our footsteps and we seek out of court settlement.
Mas Benjamin, once again, you're welcome. You see, this is the second time I'm crossing path with this young man. And none of them is good. First, he attempted to ruin the life of my daughter with unwanted pregnancy. He absorbed all the good plans I had for her. But thank God, somehow, she realized there's the mistake of her life. Luckily enough, she found another life that is better than that old life, which he cannot be able to give to her. Now, he's here trying to ruin the life of their little daughter. What kind of man is this? Anyway, let me withdraw my statement and my action. Let me hear the details of the peace you are trying to make.
Mazi, I understand your anger, and I wouldn't like us to dwell much on that. We have come to ask you to tell your daughter to withdraw the case from the court. The issue of custody of the child is something we can negotiate within ourselves and work out something that everyone will be happy with. Let her withdraw the case and tell us her plans for the child. And we will look into it and know how we work with that.
Mazi Benjamin, you have spoken well. I have to talk to my daughter and get back to you.
Okay. Thank you, Soko.
Welcome.
Hey, my dear, I must really thank you for your advice. Ibekwe's mother welcomed me with her arms wide open.
Hey, you see, you see?
She says she has long waited to meet Ibekwe's girlfriend.
Eh? So what about Ibekwe? What did he say that about your unannounced visit?
Did he even allow me to sleep at night?
Hey!
So what's the next step now?
Well,
they said I should inform my people that they will be coming by month's end.
Hey.
You know, this Patricia's case has really taught them a lot. So this time around, they want to do the needful. Everything.
Hey, baby!
I'm telling you,
that is wonderful.
Yes,
I'm so happy for you.
Thank you so much. And I want to say a very big thank you again to you. This is your advice, eh? God will bless you.
Hey! better know that I'll be the chief bridesmaid.
Who again will be the chair?
Hey, my friend!
I'm so happy for you!
Hey, mommy, dear! Love, I talk up for me!
I want to show appreciation for your efforts so far. Yes, I thank you so much. Please keep us posted, right? Okay.
So my daughter is officially a missing person. It's been 24 hours now and nobody knows the whereabouts of my daughter.
Darling, the police is following every thread. And I'm sure and hopeful that your daughter will be found. But then, I think you need to eat something.
My enemy is at work. Ibekwe is at it again. Since he could not get my child through the court, he has decided to use magic to manipulate her to leave the house.
What is that supposed to mean?
I am very sure that Ibekwe is with my daughter.
How possible?
Oh, maybe he connived it Friday to kidnap my child and lied to me that she walked away from the house.
Oh, sweetheart, you are losing it. You need to calm down. Hello, hello. Yes, good. Good. Yeah, we are both at home.
What is he saying?
Oh, you mean we should stay put and wait for you? All right, we'll do just that. We'll do just that. Thank you.
What's going on?
I think they found her.
Where is she? Is she okay?
I don't know, but he said a woman came with a missing child to their police post within the estate.
Okay.
And they are on their way for us to confirm if she is the one.
What are we waiting for? Let's go there at once. Let's go.
Let's.
Hey.
He said we should wait. We should wait. We paid them for them to do this job. So let's be patient. Come on. We should be happy that it's a good news. Calm down, sit down.
Should I call them now? If they are not coming, let's go and meet them.
Darling, be patient. They said we should wait for them.
But we have been waiting.
Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome, Mr. Thompson.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
All the houses look alike. I got confused.
It's okay.
She got lost and found herself in one Mrs. Grace's compound. So Mrs. Grace gave her the place and food and brought her to the office.
Oh my goodness, God bless her for me.
I put an okra soup.
We appreciate it. Thanks so much.
So, Mr. Stein, how do I meet this Mrs. Grace? I want to appreciate her for what she did for my daughter.
With the information we've gathered, she stays in the estate.
Okay.
So when I get to the office, I will scout for her number and send it across to Mr. Thompson.
That would be nice. Thank you so much. God bless you. Would you want me to give you refreshments?
Don't bother yourself. The most important thing is that she's here in one piece.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I have to be going now, Mr. Thompson.
Okay. Before you go to the office, you'll hear from me.
Thank you, sir. Next time, be very careful.
Yeah, we. Bye-bye.
All right, thank you.
Now that you are both reunited, I think I need some rest.
I'm sorry. Sorry for putting you through all this.
It's okay. I'm happy you're back to me. And you're safe. That's all that matters.
And when are you going to tell me who Mr. Thompson is to you? And why he's always walking like someone that has hunchback?
Sweetheart, Mr. Thompson is my husband. Your stepfather. I'm sure you know what stepfather means.
Yes.
And the reason he's walking that way is because he's sick. But he'll be fine.
Okay, so what's happened to my father?
Your father and I were never married.
I understand, but he's still my father. Okay, what becomes of him now? I'm gone and you're gone.
Perpetual, Ibekwe is a grown man. He will figure out his life all by himself. You don't have to worry about him.
I know. But he's my father. At least, you should do something for him. You should help him for taking care of me all this while you've not been around.
What?
Yes. Please, I know you can do it for him. I want you to help him. Help him. Help his life. Help his current situation. I don't like it now. I don't like the way he roams about the village, looking tattered, looking poor and everything. My father is a nice man. He's not a bad person. His problem is that he's poor. And I know you can help him.
Sweetheart, did Ibekwe put you up to this?
No. Please. I just wanted to do something for him. He's my father. Please. Compensate him. He's been the one taking care of me, doing everything for me.
Okay, I'll help him.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Mama! Papa! I'm back! Papa! I am back! See my phone! Yes! See my clothes!
Hey! Pepe! Pepe!
Mama!
Oh!
See me, see me!
Hey. Look at you.
See my phone. See my clothes. See my back.
You're so beautiful.
See my phone. See.
Amara, you're old.
Yes.
Now, Perpetua.
Yes.
Oh, your mother really took good care of you.
Yes, sir. Hey! Don't you like my clothes?
Hey. And your bag too. Yes. This one is your own.
It's very expensive.
Hey!
Mama, don't you like my clothes?
Your clothes is very nice.
Hi!
Yes. And they look good on you.
Let's see my phone.
Your own?
Yes.
Your own?
Yes.
Hi! Welcome, my daughter.
Thank you, Mama. Mama, how are you?
Look at me, my daughter. You are still alive. Oh, thank you very much. You took very good care of her. Look at how she's looking.
Mama, she's my daughter. I'll do anything for her.
Thank you.
Ibekwe, how are you?
I'm fine.
Mama, I want to use this opportunity to apologize to the both of you. I'm so sorry for everything. I was frustrated, I was depressed, I was stressed. I went through a lot. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry for putting the both of you through the stress and cuts. Please forgive me. Ibekwe, I'll give you the sum of 5 million naira so you can establish a business for yourself.
Hey! You are my role model.
I'll also rent an apartment for the both of you in the same estate with me.
Eh?
So both of you can be close to Perpetua.
Hey!
Hey!
Ibekwe! Hey! Mama! Ibekwe! Ogaranya! Ogaranya! Hey! Pepe mwam! Pepe mwambo! Pepe! Hey! Ibekwe! 5 million!
Pepe rami!
Oh! Thank you, my daughter. Thank you very much.
Hey!
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hey!
Ibekwe!
Mama!
Hey! Hey!
Thank you.
Perpetua Uwamu! Perpetua Uwamu!
Thank you very much.
Papa, you see, in this life, money stops nonsense. Money is everything. Before, poverty was suffocating you people. You couldn't breathe. But now, joy has come.
Joy has come, finally. I'm happy.
You see? Money is everything. So learn how to make money.
She be troublemaker number one. I'm a hachi perpetua. If she no find trouble, trouble go find her come. Now which can begin to be this year? Joy, if you want trouble now. Amarachi, go call her Kanki, and they go deal with you. But if you want make them happy, call them Perpetua. Everything will send them in there. If you want make trouble, but you call Amarachi, go call her Kanki, and they go show you Pepe. But if you want peace to run, call them Perpetua. Everything is incremental. Go be with you, but if you want make them happy,
them in the hey, yo. If you want my trouble, boy, I call Amarachi.
Amarachi,
go go hako hato. They go show you pepe. But if you want peace to run, yo, call on Pepe Chua. Everything goes in the hey, yo.